Hello my crafty friends, welcome to our channel. I am Anu, designer at Just My Craft, and today I'm back with another craft tutorial. But before we move forward, please subscribe to our channel if you haven't already and hit the bell icon to never miss a video from us.
In today's video, I'm going to show you 4 different ways to create with Just My Craft reinforcement hole punch. So let's get started. First, let's have a look at the reinforcement hole punch. On the back, you can see it's closed. So where the punch outs come out from? Wait, I will tell you in a minute. Taking a white cardstock here, insert it in the punch. Using your palm here, press it hard like this. This is the right way to use it. And the rings come out from the opening here. Now, where the center parts go, they are here. I forgot to clean this compartment. If they are stuck in these holes, use Just My Craft fine tip tweezers to pull out. Now close this up. Fit this black lid straight inside the cavity and press it down. You will hear a click sound and it's ready to use again. Now, what's the need of this punch? It is used to secure the holes on tags. Here I have this tag made with Just My Craft rounded tag punch, and this is how you place the rings. You can use a simple cardstock or use a coordinating pattern paper. Then finally add a ribbon to complete it. Now, this reinforcement ring will add extra strength to this hole against the tight knot of ribbon, and it will actually prevent it from tearing. This is an amazing tool to have if you love making tags. You can use this punch on a variety of cardstocks up to 300 GSM. Also vellum, which is a delicate paper. The reinforcement hole punch is made to coordinate with Just My Craft tag punches. There are 2. Rounded and rectangular tag punches. Now let's move forward and create some tags. I have prepared few white tags in advance using both tag punches from Just My Craft. Now to this I'm simply adding this pretty sunflower I taught in my previous video, a green round ring and a sentiment. And this gives you a quick and simple tag. Again, creating a simple tag using another flower. This time I took a hexagon ring and colored it yellow with dye inks. So this way you can play with your inks to create coordinating reinforcements for your tags. Now for the next one, I created a stencil background and now I am taking a 1.5 inch circle. Also, I punched out 2 white round rings along with 2 black ones. For the black ones, I am using the center parts. Yes, I am going to make these into eyes. So this is going to be a smiley. You can also use these rings for ears or maybe tires for a car. Anything you can imagine. Finally, for the tag hole, I am adding black hexagon ring. For the next one, again I took a simple tag and adhered few round rings here and there. Now, I'm gonna cover the entire tag with a thin layer of gesso and set it dry. Then add yellow color. These reinforcement rings give a really nice texture to a plain cardstock. You can use it in your mixed media projects or your journals, etc. Once it's dried, I'm adding a flower to it and a sentiment. And finally a hexagon ring on top. For the last one, I did masking technique with the round rings and created an underwater background. These rings I created on the background depicts water bubbles. Now to create the mask, take a vellum sheet, add a piece of masking tape on it and simply punch it. Now use Dress My Craft fine tip tweezers to separate the mask. And position it on your tag. Then do ink blending on it, and this is what you will get. Now adding a starfish here and a sentiment. Finally, a round ring to finish off.
So this was all from me today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, do give it a thumbs up, leave some love in the comments and share this video with your friends. Also, all the supplies I've used in this video are linked in the description box below. You can check there. So now I'll take a leave and I'll be back again with another craft tutorial. Until then, see you and happy crafting.